So this is going to be a short video on Tawheed, the Islamic belief, which is arguably the most important belief to all Muslims, and it's certainly one that all Muslims consider a central belief within their faith. Okay, so what does Tawheed mean to begin with? Well, we can take the literal kind of definition of it as being the oneness and unity of God. That definition itself might seem like it's a fairly simple idea. Oneness and unity of God. Well, what are we saying here? We're saying that Muslims believe that there is only one God. So surely Tawheed just means that Muslims are monotheists. Mono meaning one, and theism meaning belief in God. And whilst that is true, we can tell from the belief or the definition of Tawheed that Muslims are monotheists, there's a lot more to it than that. Within this one word, Tawheed, there are actually three very important concepts or beliefs that are being demonstrated for Islam. So number one, Tawheed is suggesting that God is unique. So no matter how far you search, high and low, throughout the world, or indeed beyond our world, you're never going to find anything like God. God is unique. Tawheed also suggests that God is indivisible, meaning can't be divided, so you can't kind of break God down into fractions or parts or anything like that. God is only ever one whole thing. And finally, we've got the idea of unity. So within Tawheed, we're suggesting that there is a unity within Islam. What we're going to do in this video is we're going to have a quick look at these three key concepts within Tawheed. So the idea of uniqueness, indivisibility, and unity. I'm going to tell you a little bit more about them and the implications of them for Muslims, and then give you some suggestions of ways in which the life of a Muslim might be influenced by these three concepts. So remember, in essence, what we're saying here is that this one word, Tawheed, the oneness of God, whilst that might be its definition, there are also three things being suggested by that one word. So firstly then, the idea that God is unique. God being unique means that God isn't really comparable or like anything else in the universe, any other being that exists. So we can't accurately say God is like anything, because whatever we compare God to, it will be inaccurate. If we say God is like love, God is like kindness, God is like justice, all of these words on their own can't ever be exactly what God is. None of them have enough within them to encompass and to include everything that God is. In Islam, though, Muslims do have 99 commonly used names for God. So these are really kind of varied in what they suggest about God, but none of the names, or even all of the names put together, really fully capture what it means completely accurately when we talk about God, what God is. And that's because God is just so unique. There isn't anything else that's like God. There is no word or phrase or collections of words and phrases that can accurately say what God is. So even though there's 99 in Islam, none of them really, and even all of them combined, do justice to what God is, according to Islam. In terms of how the uniqueness of God influences Muslims in their lives, well, some Muslims, particularly Sufi Muslims, actually recite the names of God. So they might be given a particular name of God that describes a characteristic that they don't personally have but want to have, and then they will be asked by like a teacher to recite that name to remind themselves of it on a daily basis. So if you were someone, say, who wasn't very merciful or very forgiving of other people and you like held a grudge, then perhaps the merciful might be one of the names of God that you were asked to recite. And so Muslims do use prayer beads to kind of repeat all of the 99 names over and over again in a sort of a meditation-like fashion. So they'll kind of count the prayer beads as they go to remind them of how many names that they've gotten to. And it's really beautiful to hear. It's almost like kind of musical, the way that it's recited, similar to the call to prayer. So the second part of Tawheed and its concepts that it encompasses is the idea that God is indivisible. So what do we mean by indivisible? As I've said before, it means that God can't be divided. So if you think about it like a fraction, you can't break God down into fractions. It just doesn't work. Okay, there is only ever one God. We can't have, for that reason, any family members of God. So God doesn't have a family tree with a mum, a dad, children, etc., brothers and sisters. That's just not possible. The concept of Tawheed means that there is only one God which can't be divided in any way. God is the one being that created the universe alone, and God isn't dependent upon anything else to exist. If he did have mum and dad, then obviously God's existence would be dependent upon his mum and dad existing, in the same way that our existence is dependent upon our parents existing. That doesn't work for God. And this is really an important distinction between Islam and Christianity, because whilst in Islam, Jesus or Isa is believed to be a prophet, a messenger of God, he isn't believed to be God's son or God incarnate, because that's just not possible. In terms of how that influences Muslims in their day-to-day life, this indivisibility of God, it means that Muslims do not treat anything but God as though it is worthy of worship. So nothing else in the universe is worthy of being worshipped in the same way that God is. If Muslims do treat something or someone as though they are worthy of worship, it's actually the one unforgivable sin in Islam. So to put anything above God is to commit the sin of shirk, and that is the one thing that cannot be forgiven. So because of that, obviously Muslims don't worship statues or idols, and you also won't see images of God being drawn in mosques and places of worship or in Muslims' homes, because then you might end up worshipping the images and not God itself. It also means that in a Muslim's life, everything essentially comes second to God. So God is literally above all things. And that includes your wealth, your family, anything to do with your lifestyle, anything in your life would always come second to or be below God. And that might seem a little bit harsh. I mean, why wouldn't you put your family above God? Well, because essentially the reason you have your family, you have money, you have a lifestyle that you do, is because God has chosen to give it to you. So you should always put God above all of these things. So finally, the concept of unity within Tawheed means that Muslims believe there is only one God who created one human family for one purpose. Okay, so one God, one human family, and one purpose. And that purpose is essentially to be united with God. So the only God which exists has created one human family, the human race, and all of those humans as individuals have the same one purpose. So this, for Muslims, this idea that there is one human family means that God doesn't have a chosen people. So within some other Abrahamic religions, particularly Judaism, God has chosen a specific group of people for a particular destiny that are going to kind of fulfill a purpose that God has given to them uniquely. That isn't the case in Islam. So all humans, regardless of who you are, where you are from around the world, you all have this one purpose of uniting eternally with God. And you all have the same ability to achieve that purpose, and you all have the same ability to connect to one God through prayer and through your actions. And Muslims do believe that to keep people remembering this idea of their one purpose. In terms of how this concept of unity might influence Muslims, well, two obvious ways are that you're going to treat all of humanity and all humans that you interact with as though you are part of the one human family. You're not going to discriminate or treat people unfairly because of who they are or where they're from, etc. We're all one human race. Muslims also might like to read the Quran and read the words of God, because in so doing, in so reading the Quran, they will be reminded of this central message of unity, of being connected to one God, of there being one human family, and all humanity having one purpose. The Quran will help them to remember that. So although Tawheed is a belief, it's something that Muslims kind of have faith in and have in mind and in their minds and in their hearts, it shouldn't just be something that they keep within their minds and in their hearts. It is important to Muslims that they kind of, that idea of Tawheed affects their day-to-day lives and the choices that they make. So again, how do they interact with their fellow humans? What do they choose to do for an occupation? How do they choose to raise their families? All of these ideas should be influenced or come from the fact that they've got this idea of Tawheed in their mind at all times. So to very quickly recap, whilst Tawheed as a word does indeed mean the oneness and unity of God, within that kind of central belief, you do have these three other kind of concepts: uniqueness of God, the indivisibility of God, and the unity of God. So this one word encompasses and kind of captures the meaning of three very different and important ideas and beliefs about God for Muslims.